Obviously, the pandemic has not yet ended, so the work we do at the School of Education, which our head of school so kindly referred to, links to what I would like to briefly talk about. The pandemic is not over, but we can see already clearly the tragic consequences of the pandemic, and in that sense we will be exploring today links learning in knowledge societies after COVID-19. Just to mention one dimension which I think is central, even before the pandemic the world's total debt was 244 trillion, and by the end of 2020 it has increased to 281 trillion, which is more than 355% of the global domestic product, according to the Institute of International Finance. Could we move to the next slide? The debt was already quite high even before the pandemic, as you can see in this diagram. Now, the problem is that this debt is, so to say, passed over to the next generation. There is a recent report by UNICEF referring to the next generation of children and young people as the generation COVID, in the sense that they will be living in far harder conditions around the whole world than previous generations did. At the same time, there are new possibilities emerging. Could we move to the next slide? So before the pandemic, 830 million children and young people from around the globe were online daily. And this number is constantly increasing. We talk a little bit about this in one of our recent publications, Global Youth in Digital Trajectories. There is a number of about 5 billion mobile broadband subscriptions globally. So there are significant new opportunities for learning and inclusion in what we can call rapidly evolving knowledge societies. And I'm Greek. Could we move to the next slide? Many colleagues talk about crisis in terms of belonging and inclusion and exclusion currently. Crisis in Greek entails a positive dimension in ancient Greek as well. So it means the turning point of a disease, a time of intense difficulty, but also a time when a difficult or important decision must be made, which is precisely where we're now, a crisis point of history. So it's the moment to decide, to eventually evaluate the past and take a different dimension. And in that sense, let's move to the next slide, please. It's important to think about links in terms of relational innovation across disciplines and sectors. So we refer to links in terms of learning and neuroplasticity or neurodiversity, literally establishing links, connections between the neurons in the human brain. Links can refer to learning and design, the synergies between humans and devices and open access to knowledge, including critical epistemologies developed in the global south. Links refers to the qualitative difference in the relationships between peoples. It's about transforming learning and transforming the society, creating more inclusive societies, establishing links for collaboration as opposed to competition. And all this can happen across diverse geographical settings and in a global perspective.